So if you want to record your screen and your camera in Descript, Descript will record it in multi-track, which means it's going to record your screen separately, your camera separately, your audio is going to be a separate file. You can separate, you know, and so on. So everything's separate. But Descript will also automatically assemble a sequence for you. So it's going to put those files in sync in a sequence and create a composition for you. So this is what I did with a project that I recorded a while ago. And this one here, Camtasia Audio Narrate Part 2. It's because I had to record it in two parts. So this is me recording my screen and my camera in Descript, but it was a tutorial about Camtasia. So if you look in the project files area, these are my compositions here, but look at the files, right? So I've got recordings. So my recordings have two files. It's my Christie iPhone camera, because I record through my iPhone, and my screen, okay? If I click on these files, this is what they look like. You see, this is my screen, okay? So I'm kind of going around and kind of going through the file. And then if I click the other file, this is me on camera, okay? Two files. And each one has audio as well, all right? So this is, if you record using the Descript recorder, which is available here in the record tab, you can see here, you select your phone, you select your sound output and your screen sharing, which I'm not going to enable now. So when you select these sources to record, it's going to separately record them in separate files. And then what's going to happen is it's going to create the sequence right there. If you look in sequences, you see the sequence is here, okay, with two tracks. If I open this, right click edit, you see, there you go. You've got two tracks. You've got your webcam and you've got your screen. Now, these are two files. And in here, in the sequence, they are unedited. Now, the next thing that happens is you take that sequence. Let's right-click on this and rename it. Both tracks, okay? I'm just going to rename this. So right-click on this and create a composition now. There you go. So this is called both tracks, same as the sequence. And there you go. Look, you've got these tracks now available for you side by side. You can manipulate them. You can move them around like this. I can create a picture-in-picture if I want to. So let's say that I get my, you know, my screen. I'm going to pull the screen full screen like this. I'm going to resize it. And then my camera, I can move it in the corner. I can maybe change the cropping, put it in a circle like this, and move it around with the double click, go into crop mode to double click it, and then resize it like this. And there you go. My face looks priceless in here. Anyway. So these are the two tracks that you can manipulate individually in Descript once you've recorded everything. How about if you've made edits? So let's say that you've gone through your composition in here and you maybe deleted some things, you know, with ignore, and you've deleted this part, and you've deleted, I don't know, this part in here, and blah, blah, blah. Maybe you remove filler words and hesitations and things like that, retakes. Okay. So in the end, your edited tutorial is now shorter than the files, of course, because you've got all these edits in there. How do you now take those files separately with the edits in them and export them somewhere else? Well, the only way to do that is to actually export the composition twice. Okay? So let's say that, you know, I've got the edits in here. So I've got, I'm going to actually go and delete far more than I should. You know, I'm just going to remove some stuff in here, blah, blah, blah. So now look, my tutorial is now 4 minutes long. If you look down here in the timeline, I'm going to cut the ending. I'm going to do more stuff, you know. So now my tutorial is 3:47, okay? If I look at the sequence, my sequence is 5 minutes because that's not edited, right? What I've done, my edits, I've done them in this composition in here. So now I want to export these two things, the screen and the camera, as separate files while keeping these edits, okay? So here's how you do it. I'm going to make this one full screen because if you want to edit in another program, then you don't care about the talking head thing in the corner. You don't want to export that little circle. I don't care for that. I want to export my full-size, full-frame camera view as a separate file. And then I want to do the same for my screen, okay? So one way is to do, look, I'm filling my screen with my camera and I'm going to go to publish and I'm going to go export. And here I'm going to select, you know, 1080p, whatever, and export my video. You can do the same with the publish online. But this one gives you the file, you download it locally, your computer works a little harder, but it's doesn't mean that when you save that file, upload in the cloud, it's going to overwrite it. So, you know, I want to do this here. So I'm going to export this one first. So this is my camera. Okay. This is my camera view. When you're done exporting that, you save it, my camera file, whatever. Then you come back in here and you click on the camera and you can do two things. You can right click on it and say, right click layer order and send to back, which will put the camera behind the screen, you know? And now you go again to publish and export again. The same composition, but this time it's going to save the screen, okay? Both of those files are going to have audio on them, the same audio, and you're going to end up with two files, screen and camera, all down to 3 minutes 47, whatever they are, how long they are, with all the edits in them, so you can now put them in another program and do more stuff. And this actually, this workflow is something that you can do with audio as well, because a lot of people edit audio only, and they say, you know, I have an interview with two people, different tracks, I've edited the whole thing, so it's a composition now, but I want to export still the separate tracks on that audio composition separately, but keep the edits. Well, this is the same way, except that in audio case, because you don't have them in front of the other whatever, you've got audio to deal with. In that case, if it's not a video composition, then you go in the sequence, you edit that sequence, and you say, look, if this is one audio file, I'm going to go in solo. From the top right, you go solo track, which what this does is it just lets that track play and mutes all the other tracks. You solo that track, you click done, you come back in here and export, publish, export, audio, export. That's going to just export that one track. And if that track has like gaps in it because the other people were talking, those portions will be, you know, silent. And then when you're done with this first track, track one, you go back in here, right click, edit sequence, on solo track, whatever, you go to the second track, solo that one, export again. If you don't need to edit inside of Descript and you're just using Descript to record with, then honestly, you don't need to do all that stuff that I did. You can just go in here to the recordings area. You can right click on a file and say download. Okay. This is if you're on the web, right? If you're on the desktop app, this button says copy file to Explorer if you're on Windows, or copy file to Finder. So that's going to save that original file to your disk so you can put it in another program.